I'm going to do a video about how to change your pointer, your cursor arrow, so you can see it. As you get a little older, it's harder to see things. And Windows gives you the standard size little white arrow, and 90% of the time you're working on white backgrounds, and it's easy to lose it. So I thought of, before I show you how to make your own cursor, I thought I'd show you a couple of basics here. The cursor is not actually an arrow. It's a 48 by 48 pixel box, and most of it is invisible, and all you see is the arrow. So I just changed it. You can see I've got a green box moving around here on the screen, and the top left corner of the box is where the arrow actually points. And you can get pretty creative. You can use a box if you want. You can put a one with a hole in the middle. Yeah, click apply here. See, you can see through it there as you go over stuff. You can even use a picture as a pointer. Here's my Mojo 60 icon. Bilo the Wonder Dog, and I click apply, and there you go. And I can use that. But the reason I'm doing this video is because I got tired of trying to find that white mouse, and I made myself a large bright colored one that I can see. And this is it. I'm not going to show you how to make this particular one, but I'm going to show you the basics. So if you want to make your own cursor, you can. And first thing we need is to go to a program like Photoshop or GIMP. I use GIMP. It's a free program. It's like Photoshop, but it's the poor person's version. And I'm going to go there and show you how to make an icon. Okay, I've started GIMP. Now I'm going to go up to File and click on it and click New. And I'm going to change it to pixels. If it's not already pixels, change it to pixels. And it doesn't matter what size you make it. I like working with 400 by 400. It shows a little more detail while you're working on it. When you get through all saving it, Windows is going to make it go down to 48 by 48 pixels without on its own. So ...400 by 400, click OK, there it is. Come over here and right click on background. And click Add Alpha Channel. What that does is, anytime you delete something, that deleted area will become transparent. And now I'm going to come up here and choose the Free Select tool, and I'm going to come down here, and this is just the basics. You can get as elaborate as you want on drawing these things. I'm going to click right on the bottom corner here, and I'm going to come up here and click on this corner. And I don't know if you've ever noticed it or not, but every arrow in Windows, your cursor there, the left-hand edge is always perfectly vertical. It's not on an angle or anything else. Only the other edges are on an angle. Sorry, just trying to get right on the corner here. There we go. Click, and then I'm going to come over here, and you can draw this any way you want. I'm just going to eyeball a quick one here. Click, and I'm going to come in on a bit of an angle. Click, come down here. Click, click, here and double click. And now I'm going to make it a bright color. So I'm going to choose my fill tool, the bucket. Then I'm going to click on the black here. And we're just going to choose a nice bright color. We'll go with this pinky purple. Click OK. Click fill. And then I'm going to do Control-I, which is invert. Right now, it's only letting me work on the inside of the arrow I just drew. But I want to get rid of this outside, and I can't work on that. So I'm going to do Control-I, which makes it so the outside is what we're going to work on. And then I'm going to hit Delete. And now only that purple part will show when I use this pointer. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do Control-I again. Now I can work on the inside of this again. I'm going to come up here to Filters. I'm just going to get a little fancy. Nothing spectacular. And come down here to where it says Decor. You don't even have to do this. Decor. And I'm going to choose Add Bevel. Whoops. It says work on copy. I don't want to do that. I'm just going to get rid of that. I'm going to raise this up to 7. Click OK. That beveled the edge a little. I'm going to do it again. Control F will redo the bevel again. Or you can just come up here and click Repeat Add Bevel. I'm going to do it one more time. Control F. Okay, now I'm gonna choose select none. And I'm gonna do file, export. I'm gonna export it to my desktop because it's easier for me to find it. And I'm going to give it a name. I want it to show up at the top of the list, so I'm going to do 1A. And you want to save it as .ico, which I already have here, .ico. And I'm going to click Export. And right here it says Compress. Don't want to compress it. And it says 32... BPP. I'm going to change it to the 8.1. I've played around with this a while, and 8BPP, 1 bit alpha, 256 slot palette, works the best. So I'm going to click that. Now I'm going to click export. And now I'm going to remove this. Okay, I've opened up my desktop folder, and right here it says 1A.ico. Well, it can't be an ICO. It has to be a CUR, but there is the program. GIMP doesn't let you save it as a CUR, but if you save it as an ICO, once you've got it saved, you can go to where you saved it and change the ICO to CUR. And then hit enter. If you change a file name extension, the file might become unusable. Are you sure you want to change it? Click yes. Then open your C drive and open your Windows folder, and then in the Windows folder find the cursor folder, which I have over here on the left already open. Drag this from my desktop into the cursor folder, and it says you will need to provide administrator permission to move this folder. Click continue, and it's moved. So then come down in the left corner and click your start button. Sorry, it's not on the screen. Click control panel. Let me move this over so you can see it. click Appearance and Personalization, then come up here and click Personalization again. And then over here on the left it says Mouse Pointers. Click that. And Normal Select, that's the one that's the arrow that you see 99% of the time. Click that so it's highlighted in blue. Then click Browse. And hopefully it's already on your cursor folder. If not, you got to find your cursor folder in Windows. And then find the one you're looking for. Here's 1A, showing down here in the left corner. Click Open. Open. Then click Apply. And you can see I now have this one. And mine, now you can see I've changed the rollover one, mouse over, to turns to a hand. I took that from a photo and cut it out. You can get pretty elaborate if you want. Here it is, link select. So whenever I go over a link, it turns to that hand. Those are the only two I've changed. Well, that's the basics. I hope you've liked it, found it interesting. If you did, please consider giving it a thumbs up. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. God bless. Bye.